A very good morning to one and all present here in this fine morning, and respected our principal sir, Dr. Prasannakumar Dutta sir from Bahuma College, Jorhat, Assam, India. Respected our today's eminent resource person, Dr. Kamrujaman Majumdar sir for Stanford University, Bangladesh. Respected Mr. and Mrs. Adam from Kripa Disti Publications from Pune, India, and all our delegates and participants who are present here in this webinar. I am Dr. Sangeeta Das, Assistant Professor, Department of Botany, and also the Coordinator of Institutional Biotech Hub from Bahuna College, Jorhat, Assam, India. Take this privilege to welcome all of you who have gathered here, who are present with us in this international webinar on pollution and environment organized by Institutional Biotech Hub, Bahuna College, in association with Kripa Disti Publications from Pune, Maharashtra, India. So we all know what is pollution, how pollution is affecting our day-to-day life, our air, water, soil, everything is getting polluted. And the big question is that how we are going to mitigate, what we are going to live for our future generation so that they too can sustain peacefully like we are living on this planet. So to discuss about all these things, we have with us our resource person. But before that, to inaugurate formally this international webinar, I would like to invite our respected principal, sir, Dr. Prasannakumar Dutta, to kindly inaugurate this international webinar and to say a few words to this online audience who have gathered here. Sir, please.
Thank you, Sangeeta. Good morning, everybody. I, as the principal of Bahuna College, welcome Professor Kamrujaman Majumdar, Dean, Faculty of Science, Professor and Chairman, Department of Environmental Science, Stanford University, Bangladesh. It is my pleasure to have Professor Majumdar with us in this webinar on the occasion of National Pollution Control Day. I also welcome Dr. Sangeeta Das, Coordinator of Institutional Biotech Hub of Bahuna College, teachers and students of different colleges, and all other respected audience to this webinar. Established in the year 1966, Bahuna College has always worked for the betterment of the people belonging to the rural areas through various activities. It has worked to provide quality education to the students from all sections of the society in both arts and science team. We have been organized seminar, workshops, and popular talks at different levels. Today's webinar is such a program organized by Biotech Hub of this college in association with Kripa Disti Publications on the occasion of National Pollution Control Day. As we all know that pollution is the introduction of contaminants into the natural environment that cause adverse change. Pollution can take the form of any substance, solid, liquid, or gas, or energy, such as radioactivity, heat, sound, or light. Pollutants, the components of pollution, can be either foreign substance, energies, or naturally occurring contaminants. Although environmental pollution can be caused by natural events, the word pollution generally implies that the contaminants have an anthropogenic source, that is, a source created by human activities. Rise of human civilization is directly linked with increase in pollution. Actually, it started with the introduction of fire in our daily life. Now it is not possible to avoid the man-made modern amenities. So we have to think about sustainable development for better living with lesser harm to the environment. I hope today's webinar will throw light about strategy for controlling pollution. Once again, I thank Dr. Majumdar for your gracious presence in this webinar, sparing your much valuable time. And I would like to inaugurate this webinar, wishing it great success. Thank you. Thank you, Sangeeta.
Thank you so much, sir. Now, I would like to request Mr. Adam from Kripa Drishti Publications to kindly introduce our today's eminent resource person and to continue with the schedule of this webinar. Thank you.
Thank you, Sangeeta ma'am. Hello, good morning and welcome to this international webinar. So here we have our speaker, Professor Dr. Ahmad Kamruzzaman Mazumdar, sir. He is the Dean of Faculty of Science, Chairman of Department of Environmental Science at Stanford University, Bangladesh. He is also the founder and director of Center for Atmospheric Pollution Studies. He is also Joint Secretary for Bangladesh Parivesh Andolan. And he has a number of papers to his credit, too many to elaborate and mention in this short introduction. So I would hand over the mic to Professor Dr. Kamruzzaman Mazumdar, sir. Please continue, sir.
Thank you very much. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
So I'm going to directly to my presentation. Just a minute, please. Nasir, I'm going to help you. This one. Interesting. Google Meet.
Yeah, please continue, sir. There seems to be some network issue, but please continue.
Yes, yes.
Hello, all. There seems to be some technical issue at Dr. Kamruzzaman Mazumdar, sir. Please allow him to rejoin. We're able to see your presentation, sir.
Yes, please, please. I'm extremely sorry. Please allow me what's the end. Because of network issue in one computer, I need to shift another one.
No problem. We understand, sir. Please so, take your time.
Yeah. Is that visible now, the first slide?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Okay, it is visible.
Okay. So in my side, I cannot see anything from your side, the audience side. So please forgive me. Allow me to start. So very welcome to this very important session organized by Institutional Biotech Hub, Bahana College of Assam, India, in association of Kripa Drishti publication. And I would like to express my sincere thanks to our Honorable Principal, Dr. Prasanna Kumar Dutta, and Dr. Sangeeta Das, of coordinator of Institutional Biotech Hub of Bahana College of Assam. So this is a very important issues for not only for Bangladesh, but also for whole subcontinent, that we all are actually facing a number of issues in our social, in our personal life, in our even national life. So above all, these environmental issues actually that plays in top of all these things. And nowadays, this became a very crucial for actually underdeveloped and developing countries, because the developed countries somehow they are managing their pollution, and we cannot because of our economical limitation. That's why for Bangladesh, India, Nepal, Bhutan, Pakistan, and the subcontinental other countries facing a huge problem because of environmental pollution. Today, I will try to give you some of the overview of the environmental condition here in Bangladesh, especially for Dhaka city, for air quality, for noise quality, for water quality, and some other issues like waste management. And at the end of my presentation, I will be sharing a very recent issue of Buriganga River that I'll be sharing with you. So, as all of we know that air pollution is very important parameter for ranking our city life or city environment. So what World Bank report said, World Bank report said that in Bangladesh, even in the year 2015, 2.34 lakhs death is associated or linked with environmental pollution. And out of that, 80,000 in urban areas. Another study or another report by Economist Intelligence Unit, they reported Dhaka is the world's fourth least livable city for 2021. And that was actually third least livable city in 2020 and second livable city in 2019. So Bangladesh is in the top position air quality by the air quality report of IQAR. They said in terms of air pollution, Bangladesh consecutively in 2019 and 2020, Bangladesh is the, as a country, Bangladesh is the top. And in the other point, as a capital city, Bangladesh is the fourth. In the year 2018, 1,58,000 people died due to air pollution in Bangladesh. Health Effect Institute reported that 5 out of top 10 diseases that cause death in Bangladesh are linked to air pollution, according to WHO. So this is some information you can see. And this is a historical data. And that actually showed how other pollution are being beaten by the air pollution for Bangladesh. And we can see from here, in the year 1990, then the main problem was like unsafe water, sanitation, and hand washing. That was the main problem in that time in terms of mortality and in terms of morbidity. You can see in the right graph. So over the year, we can see that you can just observe this green bar. It is 1990. Then after 5 years, 1995. So water-related problem are being solved over the year. So it is 2000, 2005, 2010, and 2016 information after that. So water problem are being solved. But you can see ambient particulate matter pollution and household air pollution from solid fuel, also lead exposure and occupational risk. So those actually started getting high, or that remain almost same. So that remains almost same. And also that is delays as well as the mortality factors. So while talking about air pollution, these are the some of the root cause of air pollution here in Dhaka. And I know by the newspaper and media that Delhi and some other cities of India, then capital city of Kathmandu, then Lahore also facing almost similar type of problem, but maybe intensity is, can be differ, but the nature and sources of air pollution that we all the neighboring countries are facing are almost same. So for Dhaka, in the middle picture, that Brooklyn, so I have the number one pollution source even 10 years ago. But nowadays, mega project, like here you can see that metro rails, then MRT, BRT, that mega project, all three, four mega project are being implemented here in Dhaka. And you can see this whole the project area, and this is very narrow, 10 to 15 feet road is there. So what we are doing, just uplifting our road from ground to in the sky. So, and as a result, just a lot of traffic jam, and due to construction material carryings and construction, a lot of air pollution is there. And this is the uncontrolled road maintenance activities going on here. And this picture is from vehicle emission and road dust emission. And in the down, this is the biomass burning. If I consider the percentage of those shores, then this construction work that they contribute almost 31%, bricklayers 30%, then biomass burning is around 10%. Then from cooking, another 10%, and rest of the 10%, we thought of that it is coming from the neighboring country as a transboundary air pollution. So what actually our news and media is telling, during the COVID time in 2020, starting from the end of the April, when a government imposed the COVID-19 lockdown, that time air quality has increased magically. So this was one of the news in the popular newspaper, that magical reduction in July 2021, and that was happened even May 2020 as well. So, it is another news that the air quality has improved a number of fold here in Dhaka. And so what our historical data said about our air quality? You know the air quality index. So air quality index represent the air quality that is suitable for the inhabitant of a city. And in the year 2016, our AQI, annual AQI for, it was average annual AQI for 136, which was unhealthy. So normally AQI below 50 is healthy, and 50 to 100 is it is a moderate, then 100 above, that is unhealthy for the sensitive group. And 150 is unhealthy for everyone. So in the year 2060, the AQI was 136. That is somehow it was moderate. Then the annual for 2017, and then 2018, 2019, and 2020. So after 20, we can see that air quality has never been in a good situation for the Dhaka city people. And as it is the average of whole city, and for Dhaka, you know, the winter and have a effect on increasing air quality or deteriorating air quality, then the average, even average is showing 150 or something around 150, but that is diluted by the very good air quality during the monsoon. So June, July, August, September, these four months is the monsoon season, and only 10% of the whole year, this time we the pollution load are seen during this period. But November, December, January, February, these 4 months, we observed that 60 to 65% air pollution are being observed only during these 4 months. So during winter season that we are now passing through, that time the air pollution has increased a number of fold, and sometime that is even 10 to 15 times higher than the national standard of 65 microgram per day for daily concentration. And in the right side, you can see another graph that almost all over the week, the air quality remained the same. And it is AQI 140, and the maximum is 148. The lowest is 140 in the Sunday. This is the average value for 5 years. So weekly variation or daily variation. So there is no weekly or significant daily variation in terms of air pollution for Dhaka city. So another information I would like to share. In Dhaka city, the morning time, we observe the worst quality of air. So the morning work is not encouraged by the air pollution researcher for the city dwellers. So starting from very early in the morning or late night, up to 8 a.m., this time is one of the highest air pollution are being observed for Dhaka city. And from this table, you can observe this is a study during COVID time. And we observed that like April, May, this 2 month observation, when Delhi reduced its 45.44% of air pollution during 2020, when COVID lockdown started, compared to 2018 and 19, that time Kathmandu reduced 37%, then Lahore reduced 44%, Calcutta reduced 34% of their air pollution. That time Dhaka could reduce only 23% of its pollution. So that is one of the alarming situation for Dhaka. Even during lockdown, everything is locked. We could not reduce our air pollution. So this is another graph where it was showed that during winter time, very unhealthy. Out of all, we observed 44% of very unhealthy air quality and 45% extremely unhealthy air quality. And so during winter, we could not manage to provide clean air for our citizen, even not for a single day. You can observe zero. So that is a very alarming thing. But in the monsoon time, you can see we enjoy some 20% day. We observe good quality of air and like 54% of moderate type of air quality. So well, monsoon is a big blessing for a country like Bangladesh in terms of reducing air pollution. Another very alarming parameter is this lead pollution. So we thought of that lead pollution has been phased out with introducing the leaded fuel here in Bangladesh. But in many research nowadays, get the evidence that in Dhaka city and Khulna, that is close to West Bengal, Khulna city, and in some other city in the middle of the country, they are having a huge exposed of this lead concentration, lead contamination. For both air, water, and soil sample, it was found that the lead concentration is getting high in some of the area. So this is an ongoing activity, research activity by Center for Atmospheric Pollution Studies of Stanford University. Under this program, we are monitoring in 10 locations for air and noise quality for Dhaka city, and that will continue for next 2 years. And initial findings from that study, ongoing study, in the month of April, May, or June, July, this is a fully monsoon season for Bangladesh. And somehow for PM 2.5, that means the particulate matter having an aerodynamic characteristics of 2.5 micron, that is, we can say, very small particle that observed here in Dhaka. In April, in some location, it was above the national standard of 65 micron gram. But in most of the time after April, May, June, July, that is within the standard. But we can observe that for the PM10 here, this PM10 concentration again, that is within the standard. You can see our Bangladesh standard for PM10, that is 150 microgram per cubic meter. But in all 4 months, the particulate matter, that is a bigger size particle, that is within the standard. But when we talk about PM2.5 or smaller type particles, that is, in some cases, it is above the standard. So as I mentioned, that only 10% of our annual pollution load can be observed during the wind monsoon season. So this is the reason why monsoon season is actually producing less pollution. So it is not that directly that monsoon region is producing less air pollution, but it is better to say monsoon is having a washing effect to reduce the produced air pollutant. That the shores never been stopped, but because of natural control, we are enjoying some good air quality. Now, talking about the research and publication in terms of air pollution, I'm very sorry to share with you that we could not manage to do very good air pollution study here in Bangladesh, even 3-4 years ago also. You can see it started 1995, the first air pollution related publication are being available in the internet, and then it was not shown is very upper curve. But in recent time, a number of researchers and a number of scientists, they started working on the air pollution and atmospheric pollution, other related activities they started. So this is all about the air pollution. Now talking about the noise pollution, as all of you know that it was said that the silent killer, but it is the most exposed killer for our society. In Dhaka, some of the school-going students are afraid of coming in the street. Traffic police are, 20% traffic police are suffering hearing loss. And street vendors, drivers, and contractors of the vehicles, they are also suffering a huge level of air pollution and noise pollution impact. So when talking about noise pollution, the traffic noise is the number one source for Dhaka. Then like construction activity, then industries, the household activity, social, cultural, and political activities that are creating noise pollution. Let me share with you very interesting findings. This is one of the recent study. In the year 2019, the government suddenly declared the secretariat area. In the right side, this is the secretariat area. Government declared this will be a noise-free or sound-free or horn-free area. Without taking any intervention, properly communicating with the people, they declared it as a silent zone. And what happened, when we started our study, that the government is going to declare this area as a silent zone. So we started our background survey, and in the background survey, what the decibel we found, that is much lower than when the government started, they are implementing the noise-free zone. That means After declaring the noise-free zone, the noise pollution has increased almost 8.5%. So that is the one of the very good example of bad implementation of environmental compliance. So, and later part, the Department of Environment, they start talking with the community people, the drivers and stakeholders. So that is somehow better than the previous situation. And in another recent study in Dhaka city, in terms of noise pollution, you can see the last table, the last column of this table, that in the silent area, that means the school, college, mosque, then the mandir, girja, so all these religious place and educational place, these are the government or national standard is for noise pollution is 45 decibel. And only 0.5% time we found that sound level, sound quality is within the standard. That means 99.45% time is above the standard. So this is the outcome of three location of very important location of Dhaka city. While talking about residential area, what we found that only 1.7% residential area having 1.7% time they are enjoying sound level within the standard. And in the mixed area, 13% only. But very surprisingly, in the industrial area, they have their different standard. And because of that standard, considering the standard level, they are enjoying 81% time, the sound level within the standard. But that doesn't mean that the population, the people are enjoying a very good noise quality in the residential area. That is only that the residential area standard is higher than the other land use type of area. And this is a special variation of noise level in Dhaka city. So these whole red area, we can see the some of the clustered of in Dhaka city, very highly noise polluted area. And there are some area, those are comparatively low noise prone area. But interesting information is that the low noise prone area included that the containment of Dhaka city. So the people, the army people, military people, they somehow controlled their area as a noise free, but other part of the city are very highly noise polluted area. So talking about water and river pollution, this is the, we are very fortunate Dhaka have 5 rivers surrounded by it. And, but very unfortunate thing is that we could not manage to utilize our river, nor for the fisheries, neither for communication, good communication, nor for fisheries or tourism, as because of the pollution. In the earlier age, in the 70s or before liberation, the pollution was in the downstream of the river. Now only that shifted even after the upstream. So the whole river are being polluted now. And the aquatic biosystem has destroyed fully. This is one of the very recent study by the Stanford University. And only you can observe the dissolved oxygen here in the year 2019 and 2020. So you can see in the different location of the river where 5 mg/L is our standard. And we found a maximum of 3.1 milligram in one location of our Buriganga River, that is the main river of the Dhaka city. And in some location, it is 0.5 only milligram per liter. So dissolved oxygen, by seeing the dissolved oxygen, you can understand how the river health is here in Dhaka. And another one of the main problem for Dhaka City that it is every day it is producing 4,500 tons of waste, but we could not manage it. We have only two landfill sites, and none of them are the sanitary landfill. So it's something like the open dumping in a dedicated location. That's all. So you, from the picture, you can observe that the Bricklanes, Brickfield is very close to the dumping site, and in the on the street, how waste are being dumped. And this is the waste management system, and the person who is managing here without any health precaution and health safety. So that is eventually that is creating the air pollution, that is creating the water pollution, that is creating the soil pollution. And as a result, what is going on? This is another ongoing study by our research team that the not only the slum area or low economic group area, the microbial air pollution has spreaded even in the upper class residential area. So this study, these findings is like 2 months ago, this study showed that a number of pathogenic bacteria that microbial pollution that are being observed even inside the air conditioned room, inside the our household, and of course in the roadside or drainage side, we found much more type of bacterial colony growth and or fungal growth we found. And very recent time, peoples of Dhaka City, they complained that they are suffering for different type of throat, nozzle, eyes, ears infection, even skin infection, and that is lasting for a month. Previously, if somebody caught by the cold or some infection, our ancestor used to suggest us, okay, have a cup of coffee or tulsi tea or warm water. And with that, indigenous type of practice could give us a relief. Nowadays, even after having a multiple type of third generation antibiotic, people are not able to get rid of it. And that has been a big concern for the city dwellers here in Dhaka. And we easily can connect this infection or microbial infection with the mismanagement of our sewerage system as well as the waste management. So these are some of the microbial colony that we recent time we found in our study. So this is all about from my side. But before that, let me share with you another environmental or ecological hazard that newly started. Like 2 years ago, when lockdown started, then Dhaka has it's called Katabon, a place, a location named Katabon. That place is popular for aquarium fish. And when lockdown started, and hundreds of aquarium fish seller, they just released their foreign species of fishes in the drain, as because they are closing down their shop and they are going to their home by closing their is it closed?
Yeah, we're able to see.
Okay. So by closing their shop, they went back to their home, and before that, they released all the fish in the drain. And what has happened, after a few months, the people, the fishermen from the riverbank, they start complaining, getting these type of new varieties of fish in their net. And last few weeks, they have found that 100,000 of shakar fish are they occupied the whole river. Now the biggest threat for all the river of Dhaka city is the shakar fish. So shakar fish are being used in the aquarium to clean it, aquarium cleaning fish, all of you know. But that fish is now transferred into the river, Buriganga, Tura, Doleshwari, Shitalokha, and local varieties of fish are not seen at all. So, and yesterday also many people came to me for this solution, and I don't know how to solve it. So we cannot take out all the water from the river and get 100 millions of shakar fish from the river, and that is already distributed in other water bodies of Dhaka and other river. So that is going to be a disaster in the coming days. So that all from my side, by saying that we should keep our nature as a natural. We should not inject pollutant and unexpected, unwanted thing in our environment. If we do that, environment will just give it back to us, and we will be that we'll be losing our livelihood, we'll be losing our health, then medical cost will be increased, and all because of we all are polluting our environment because of our uncontrolled development, not considering the environment. We all are in favor of development, but not at the cost of environment. So this is all from my side. Thank you for all of you for patient hearing. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Dr. Kamruzin Mazumdar, sir. Thank you very much for the interesting and engaging informative session.
Thank you.
So we have...
Yes, sir, please continue.
Yeah, I believe we have a few queries from the participants.
Sure, please. I'll be happy.
So I see Belavadi Sudhindra sir is asking, is there any reason why air pollution has not reduced during lockdown?
Yes, it is a very interesting issue that during lockdown, most of the public vehicles are actually closed. Let me give you one very interesting information. 17th April of 2020, the lockdown has started. But very interestingly, after 21st April, air pollution has not reduced here in Dhaka. And surprisingly, we observed that the instrument is giving us data that air pollution is almost the same, but everything is shut down. And we observed that in our previous study, we found that every day 500 tons of dust are being settled down on the surface of tree leaves in Dhaka city. It is 500 tons every day. So that means all the dust, a 500 or 1,000 tons of dust that was available on the surface of trees, leaves, and another 1,000 on other surface. So during that time, even the new air pollutants are not added, but the residual impact of previous pollution was there. This is one of the reasons. With the air, those dust started flying, and that has a proportional impact. This is the one. The second one is that during the lockdown, in the daytime, all the vehicle was closed, but in the night time, all the service providing trucks, they entered into the city, they just go through the city in the other part of the country. So those trucks actually run very quickly as roads was free. And other issue is that as all on a sudden everything locked down, lot of construction material was available on the street. So that construction material actually created a lot of dust during the vehicle movement. So that three reason we could identify so far. Thank you. There might be some other reason.
Interesting, sir. Thank you for the answer. I hope, Sudhindra, sir, your question is answered. Or you? Do you have any follow-up questions? Okay. Thank you, sir. So I have one, before we take the next question, I just have one question, sir. See, typically when we have issues to address and we have limited resources, we have a very generic kind of a solution where we have 80-20 kind of principle where we apply. So we take the smallest number of issues which are impacting the most. And when we attack those, most of our problems are then solved. So in terms of 80-20 principle or the maximum contributor of pollution, any kind of pollution, be it water pollution, noise pollution. So are there any identified contributing factors which are disproportionately contributing to the pollution so that we can tackle those first so that a large impact of pollution can be reduced?
Thank you, Adam sir. This is a very important issue, actually. This pollution issue cannot be solved by solving one issue. Rather, it is we need to bring all these things in a holistic and comprehensive approach. Whenever we consider, we ask the vehicles that you are polluting air, they start blaming that because of road condition, this situation is happening. Make the road traffic free, then we are no more polluting this environment. So every person, and if we talk with the road authority, they will be start blaming the other authority. They will be saying that water development board is continuing their service activities. So it is water development board or WASA, water supplying authority. So it is something blame gaming is going on as because of lack of city governance. So the answer of your question will be, yes, there might be an issue that if we address that, then that problem could be solved. That is the city governance. We are here as an activist. We are here talking time and again that that Dhaka city has been divided into two, that Dhaka North City Corporation and Dhaka South City Corporation. So this city governance should be actually strengthening and giving all the coordinating power to the city corporation so that they single-handedly can coordinate the activity. I repeat that they will be coordinating the activity, but activity will be done by the concerned department, no problem. But the city corporation should in a place of coordination. So in that way, maybe we can solve the problem in a holistic approach. Again, that individual issue should be addressed by the individual authority, like vehicle emission should be controlled by the BRTA, Road Transport Authority, then construction activity will be controlled by the local government engineering department. So that is the thing. But as I said, city corporation should be in the lead. Thank you.
Interesting answer, sir. Thank you. So I have Abhishek Chaudhary, sir, asking, what is the permanent solution to stop the environment pollution? And is it possible? I mean, is it really possible to stop the pollution? And whatever may be in Bangladesh or India and or any other countries, can there be a permanent solution to this?
Actually, it is very difficult to control all the pollution in one season. As all of we know that whenever there is a development, there is a like degradation of environment. If even we want to grow 1 tons of crops, that also we need to give, we need to dig the soil first, and so many other issues. So but we cannot say permanently we could solve all the problem together, especially for the environmental problem, but we should not stop by thinking that we could not do. Abhishek sir rightly mentioned that whatever the country, India, Bangladesh, or Nepal, so environmental pollution is a transboundary issue. If people from upstream of Himalaya, they pollute their river, they will go through the India and finally it will be dumped in Dhaka, it will dump in Cox's Bazar, Bay of Bengal. So to make a permanent solution, we need a regional cooperation, like India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, or Nepal, Bhutan, all the country should come in the same platform, avoiding the blaming each other, rather coming in a friendly manner, and we could solve the problem. Very recently here in Bangladesh, some of the people start saying that 40% of Bangladeshi air pollution are coming from India. I repeat, 40% of air pollution, air pollutant are coming from India because of they are burning, when they are burning the biomass, when they are burning their residual of crops, all these things, Uttar Pradesh, Assam, Haryana, even sometime from Delhi. So those air pollutant are even coming to Bangladesh. So this has not yet confirmed what is the proportion. Whatever the proportion is, that it may be 10%, it may be 20%. But what is the proportion? That proportion indicates that air pollution is not a location specific issue. Rather, it is a international or transboundary issue. And even during the summer time, when monsoon is active, pollutant actually again going back to India and up to Himalaya from Bangladesh. So it's a vice versa. It's a interlinked issue, and we should not blame each other. Rather, we need to sit together and looking for a permanent solution for environmental all the pollution. Thank you, Abhishek sir.
Rightly said, sir, because pollution is not locally impacting. It is interrelated because Earth itself is a completely interlinked and connected system. It is not isolated in countries, and countries are not derived as per the boundaries of nature. So it is an effort that needs to be taken by all the countries. It's a good point. Sir, one point I have, I wanted to ask was, see, these days there is a lot of push for electric vehicles. So electric vehicles, because they don't have the traditional pollutants coming out of them. So the nitrous oxide, carbon monoxide, those kind of emissions. So it appears that it is not polluting and it is probably safe for environment. But ultimately, at the end of the day, it still needs to be recharged, and that recharge needs electricity. Some thing has to be utilized to generate the electricity. So one option is to go for solar electricity. But as you are aware, it is only a very small fraction of the source of electricity today. And most of the time we are burning fossil fuel or diesel or those kind of things. So is there, and another effect is, at the end of the life of that battery, that lithium ion battery will be discarded, probably go into landfill. That itself will probably cause pollution. So in your opinion, what do you feel, that electric vehicles will impact positively, or it's a zero sum game?
It is a very important issue for our region. Nowadays, before that, let me share you the information that electric vehicle are not permitted here in Bangladesh yet. But we have more than 1 million electric vehicle in the country. You understand?
Interesting.
Yes. So that is, those electric vehicles are moving in the highways far from Dhaka city, not around Dhaka or Chittagong or major city, but in other district. And those electric vehicle, that is something you know about rickshaw, the popular non-motorized vehicle for Dhaka city.
Okay.
And that is a fabricated new electric vehicle. People just upgraded rickshaw into, that is local name is Nasimon, Korimon, and sometime it is said auto rickshaw. So it is an upgraded version of rickshaw, and that can run up to 60 kilometers per hour. And that is one of the major reason of road accident in the highways. Many times government declared that those are banned in the highways, but you know, somehow they are moving in the highways. Also in the district to sub-district level communication, those auto rickshaw are being used. So the information in the question you said, yes, battery operated. So battery operated vehicles are very common here in Bangladesh, and we don't have any pre-planned how we are going to manage those battery after its short cycle. As those rickshaw are very low cost, around 20,000 rupees per rickshaw only. So the battery cost is 1,000, 2,000, something like that. And those batteries are coming from China, very low quality, very less price as well. And lifetime is only 6 months to 8 months, sometimes at maximum of 1 year, that is rare. So 100,000, as I said, 10 millions of battery is being generating every year at least of, and there is no formal sector recycling or managing system introduced by the government or any other organization. So all these batteries are coming to the land, polluting the soil, polluting the water, and coming polluting the eventually the air. And in my one slide, you observed that I said there was not lead pollution for a few years in between, but nowadays lead pollution can observe all over the country. Maybe one of the reasons that battery-operated vehicles are introduced on the road, and a new type of lithium and other heavy metals are contaminating our aquatic ecosystem, soil and air. So these need to be addressed very urgently. Maybe our government will take care of this very soon, because we are talking with the government and management authority for taking care of this issue. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. So Dr. Rina Rajput, madam, is having a query. She asks, what initiatives are taken at school and college level for environmental awareness?
Yes, this is the very important issues when we talk about environment, because school and college going student will be leading our nation in the coming days. Youth is the most prioritized sector that need to be incorporated in the policy making and development, any type of development activity. And during, you know, last month, COP26 has just ended. And during COP, the youth community of Bangladesh has played a very vital role. I was there and I observed many participants from India and Nepal, youth participate, they are representing there as well. And that is the present government of Bangladesh actually giving that issue in very, keeping that in prioritized sector, the ministry, youth ministry, then also science and technology ministry, then education ministry, all those ministry actually nowadays youth are getting very hugely prioritized. The awareness campaign are everywhere in Bangladesh. You know, the Bangladesh Poribesh Andolan, the short name is BAPA, where I am also serving as a volunteer. So they have their youth group We called it Jubo Bapa. Jubo means youth, you know. So they have nationwide network, and one of our objective is to make every single student aware about their environmental pollution and pollution control. So with that objective, we are working, and Ministry of Education also providing the fund for youth mobilizing, youth movement for climate action or environmental safeguard. So this is a very important part, and in Bangladesh, this is taking care of, so far my understanding, this is taking care of with priority. Thank you, Dr. Rina, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. I hope, Rina, ma'am, your question is answered.
And at this stage, I would like to request, as I observe many young participants also here, also the organizer for like today's like webinar, in the coming days, we can jointly organize some of the youth oriented program together, where, as I am also teaching the university, so all the students can actually join in this type of event, and they can be more engaged in terms of environmental issues.
Yes, sir, definitely. We need to create more and more awareness so that everyone thinks positively and impacts positively on the environment. I have one final question from Belavadi Sudhindra, sir. He's asking your thoughts on contribution of ready-made garment industry in pollution.
Yes, this is one of the burning issue for Bangladesh, as Bangladesh is one of the leading or contributing country in terms of ready-made garments. And there are a number of sector in the garments, the number of subsector in the garment sector. One is sewing type of industry. Another is the dyeing industries. And we have leather industries also. So these leather industries and dyeing industries is killing our environment, but the sewing industries is less polluting. So in one research said that the leather industry is more polluting than its contribution to the GDP and in the revenue generation. Same for the dyeing industries. You will be surprised to know that recent time in the Facebook and social media, some of the pictures are moving, showing that this is a red river in Bangladesh. And we can invite the tourists to see those red river. The fact is that those red are the chemicals. Those red are coming from the industrial dyeing industries. So that means those rediments are, those garment industries are killing our water bodies, killing our agricultural land, killing our river. Above all this thing, very alarming thing is that some of the tube oil are giving us a red, blue, yellow type of water. So some incident happened, and it was evidenced that some of the corrupted industrial people, when the local people stopped them to releasing those wastewater into the water body, what they did, they inject those dying wastewater into the groundwater. That is very alarming. And those yellow, reddish water is coming through the tube well again. So a number of movement has been conducted by our civil society group against those type of activity. We talk with the BGMEA, that is the country coordinating garments coordinating organization, and we talk with the Ministry of Industry also, and they are looking care of it. So far, this type of occurrence has stopped, but we have a very close eyes on those activity. So the garments industry are contributing in our economy, but at the same time, they are also polluting our environment. So we need to reduce pollution, but at the same time, we need the economic development also. Our contribution from garments, we appreciate their contribution, but that should not be at the cost of environment. Thank you, ma'am.
True, sir. Because it is very alarming to know such practice, even though it is stopped now, but it is very alarming and very shocking to see that groundwater is being polluted directly by injecting the effluents into it. Very sad, sir.
Right, sir.
Okay, I believe the questions have been answered. Dr. Sangeeta Das, madam, maybe you can take, you wanted to say something. I'm sorry, I wanted to take the question, so I had to cut you off in the middle. Please carry on.
That's fine, sir. Sir, I was really impressed by your talk and what you are doing in Bangladesh through this Youth Bappa and this awareness program. So I was really interested into it because air pollution, this whole term pollution is something we need to take care of. And schools and colleges are the best places to aware our students. They should be aware about what they are doing. Then only we can use these 3 R's, sir, reuse, recycling, and this. So, sir, can we jointly think of together of doing something? Maybe online, offline is definitely not possible. Like, what we are saying is that you are... Please forgive me, sir, my daughter.
No problem.
It is okay. It is understood, ma'am. Everybody, we have kids and we are okay. We understand.
Rather, we appreciate.
Really sorry about that, sir. So what you were saying is that you are trying to aware each and every student, and that is really it's not a very easy task. So can you please elaborate, how you are doing and how maybe we can also collaborate from Assam, remote part of Assam and Bangladesh. We're very close, actually.
Right.
So can you please throw some light on it?
So I have a number of collaborative activity with a number of Indian administration. And so what actually we are practicing with them, that organizing some like youth-oriented presentation. So like we have in if I consider the my university, we have 17 student group, a student forum. Like one is called Art Forum. We have the Environmental Forum. We have Biotech Forum. So those forum, all the students should be a member of actually any two of those forum. And they do a lot of activities. And we can engage this type of one or two forum and one forum from your side or your student group and our student group. They will be discussing you, me, and we will be just listening. So in that way, they can talk. This is one thing. Other thing is that, like we are doing some of the research activity using very very easy technology. Like let me explain one. This is a tree leaves, for example. This is a tree leaves, and simple research is that we can do it jointly. This is a tree leaves in your campus. You have hundreds of plants, and we have a very low cost research idea. We have like 10, 12 research idea. Like you collect the tree leaves, go to your chemistry laboratory and wet that leaves and take out the dust from the leaves and wet separately from that dust from that leaves and measure the area of that leaves. So you can get very easily, you can get what is the dust fall concentration of certain area. So you do it there, we'll be doing the same day, we'll be doing in our 5 campus. So we can make a paper and we can jointly make a seminar. What is the dust fall concentration there in Assam and here in Dhaka? And a student will be doing that, they will be presenting that, and we'll be just participating. This could be a joint program. Just as an example, in that way, we can do some small very easygoing type of research activity, and we can engage our student in this type of activity. Or we can some environmental issue, debate, or something activity. So both side, your organization and our organization, and of course, Kripa Drishti publication could be the co-organizer or association with us. So we'll not mind, we'll be happy to get more collaborative institution. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. I'm really interested. Please share your mail ID, sir. I will very sure I will contact you. Thank you so much.
Sure. In the chat, I'm sharing my mail ID.
Yes. That will be fine. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am.
So, Mr. Adam, sir, you can continue.
Now, Rajni, ma'am, will provide.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Now, those are going to submit a book chapter. So please submit before 10th December. So we are going to publish pollution and environment book with ISBN on internationally. Okay.
Very good initiative, Rajani, ma'am.
Yeah, thank you, sir. Thank you to all.
Thank you all for your participation. And thank you, sir, for your presentation. Thank you.
Thank you. I have given my email ID in the chat. I will be happy to get one line from your side. Then we will be coordinating and communicating for a small activity, and that could be very easily we can do it. Thank you.
Sure, sir. Sure. Thank you so much, sir, on behalf of my institute, Bahana College. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, our principal, sir, and Kripa Drishti publication, Sangeeta ma'am, and all other person who worked behind organizing this event. Thank you very much. Bye.
Thank you all. So this concludes the webinar. Thank you all for joining. Have a nice day.
Thank you. Thank all.